Hello and welcome back to the Casual Gamer. The moment most ROG Ally Nobara users have been waiting for is finally here. Ladies and gentlemen, we have a functional sleep mode and it came sooner than expected. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the setup. As usual, for your convenience, the commands and links are in the description. Since I already made a previous guide for Nobara, I will not start from the very beginning. Instead, please go back to the other video and watch it up to the part where we load up Steam for the very first time, because that is where we will start in this video. Nonetheless, a link to the Nobara installer is in the description. So here we are in Steam's game mode. At this point, you have completed the Nobara installation and you were prompted to log in. We are going to enter the desktop mode. Now, this is where we're going to update Nobara. In preparation for version 39, updating is currently not as straightforward as it used to be. Using system update and the manager will end up in an error. Instead, we're going to update the system manually. Go to system and open console, then type the following to update the system. Enter your password and give permission in the next prompts. Once the update is completed, we're going to reboot. Back in game mode, we're going to return to the desktop mode again. Up next, we're going to download the 6.512 custom kernel from Jlobue10. Download the Tarball. You will find the file in the downloads folder. Tap on it and copy the location. Open the console again. Type CD, then tap on paste. Delete everything up to the downloads, then press enter. You should now be in the downloads folder. Now type tar xvf and tap on paste again. Delete everything up to the file name and press enter. This will extract the files to the RPM folder. Once done, type cdrpm and press enter, followed by sudo dnf install space star .rpm. Wait until installation has been completed and then reboot once more. We are going to return to the desktop mode. Open the console. We are going to install Steam patch, which we will need for the QAM buttons and as well for the TDP controls. Type the following. Wait for the installation to finish. Now open the pack manager and search for ASUS CTL. Tapping on it will also highlight the GUI package. Tap on confirm. Wait for the installation to finish and then we can restart the device again. Now we're almost done. You might have noticed that pressing the power button doesn't do anything at the moment, but we do have functional face buttons. Let's return to desktop mode for the last time. We're going to open console again. Then we're going to open a configuration file. Once the editor has opened, look for the following line. HandlePowerKey equals ignore and change it to suspend. Press Ctrl and O. Press enter, then press Ctrl and X. Hit enter again, confirm the file name, and you should be back in the command prompt. Let's reboot. And we are done. We can put the Ally to sleep and wake it up using the power button. and we have fully functional face buttons. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Thanks again for all the support, and hello to all the new subscribers. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.